Burlfest came about, Bill Young was a local guy, he was a banker. Well, he knew Jason.
Yeah.
And, you know, Jason and Doc, and then he knew Chet Atkins.
Yeah.
And matter of fact, this guitar, I played this guitar, this was Bill's guitar. He passed away in 92. And Murfest started in 88, but we've used this guitar, either Doc or I, or whoever wants to use it at Murfest. And we play this guitar in honor of Bill and Merle and Doc and Rosalie and the whole Watson family every year at Murfest. But, it started out as a one-time festival, and it's been going, and it usually raises about $14 million for the economy in Wells County through the college and all that. And, you know, like I say, it was originally started as a one-time concert to have a Garden of the Senses with a wall, with all in Braille and all for the blind. So anyway, it's grown from that, and we've all pitched in, and I've been there every year, and I'm proud to say that. So anyway, it's been a lot of fun, and this is a great guitar. And matter of fact, Chet actually got this guitar for Bill through the local store there before I ever had a music store. And there's a lot of history with this guitar just being played by all the artists that's used it around over the years. And so it's a privilege to own this guitar and play it in honor of all these people. So I'm tickled. And
thank you, man.
It's pretty cool. I appreciate y'all letting us be here today.
Well, and there's a fellow right there on that second bench in the talking about Merle Fest. We'll talk about that a little bit more in a while, but very instrumental in getting that started and a lot of us in digging. We're going to do one now, and when I was a little fella, I learned to play from Jason Lambert, and then an African-American up my way, and he played the song, I Don't Love Nobody. And so when I started playing some with Wayne, Wayne had a different name for the song. Tell us about that.
Well, I always called it Nothing to It, but I sort of heard that old version too, yeah. I Don't Love Nobody. And how that Nothing to It came along, I learned a lot of my picking from Doc's records, you know. And it got to be, Doc could hang out in my shop quite a bit, you know, especially in these later years. And he told me the story about this, because this same, sort of the same tune was on one of his records, and he called it Nothing to It. And he told me how it got that name. Said when he recorded that tune back in the 60s, when he put out all those LPs that made us all want to learn how to play the guitar, it had that name, Nothing to It. And he said when he recorded that, it was I Don't Love Nobody. And said the recording engineer, wherever he did that at, when he got through playing, asked him what the title of that tune was, I guess so he could write it down. And Doc misunderstood him and thought he was bragging on his picking. So he said, oh, there ain't nothing to it. that's what the fella wrote down for the title of this song. So we can,
and that's what everybody called it.
Yeah, I think that's what Doc always called it that, from the men on, you know, too. It's pretty close to the same tune, though. Thank you.
let's play this.
Let's do that, and that'd be good.
You've done, I'm a pilgrim, we want to play that one.
Yeah, do that.
That'd be a good one to play on.
I'd rather y'all play it, see you in Madrid or something.
We can do that.
Sometime today.
I like old Big Red there, don't y'all? Yeah.
I cheat, Danny, I use a flat pick some, I use finger picks too. First time I went to fiddler's, I mean, the thumb picking thing here in States with Clay started, how many years ago did you have that?
97, something like that.
Anyway, that was a great organization, Clay didn't really talk about, but he still has it today. So watch your Facebook, look for North Carolina Thumb Pickers Association, he has it every year. But anyway, he come over there and I was sitting over playing a little bit of a jam session, playing along like I do with everybody, they let me. And he looked at me, Sean, he said, what are you doing with the flat pick? I said, well, that's the only way I can play this song. And hang on, so that's sweet, and I switched back and forth. But anyway, let's do a little bit of Singing My Dreams.
Yeah, that'd be fine.
That'd be great, I'd love to hear that.
Yeah.
They closing the doors early today, and they quit serving pudding, so I won't be able to get my pudding.
That's what you got. Stay like Steve, you go extra.
Oh, that's right, stay like Steve.
That's what messed everything up.
That's what messed me up. All right, my favorite tune of Wayne Henderson's is the Carter Family Medley, and we'll do a little rhythm for you, but this, you listen to this, you'll hear the very, I guess, epitome of Appalachian guitar picking in the style of Mother Mabel and those folks. And he does it like nobody else can. And I just mean that from my heart. I really do. So I want you to listen to that. Maybe give him a little more boss man than a monitor. I appreciate it, Wayne. That's perfect. And by the way, let's give Scott a round of applause for the sound. Yes,
medley of Carter Family tune. That's who I heard when I was just a young'un, and we had a couple of their records and one of my old Vic Trolling things, you know, to play them on. But this is the very first tunes I ever learned to play on the guitar, and do a little medley of them. Some of them are sort of three-legged. I don't know if you guys keep up with them.
We'll see.
But anyway, it's a
medley. Did you say three-legged?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, you know, that's
the way the Carter family did them. They didn't expect anybody to be playing with them, I don't think.
What key?
G? Just a G chord. Just get G all the time.
I told you I'm the driver, so y'all hang on.
Anyway, this is a medley of Carter tunes, the very absolute first ones I ever learned how to play. And the Wildwood Flare would be on the end of it.
Thank you.
Well, I would like to tell you a little sad story though. I heard since we're in church, one morning this mother was trying to get her son up to go to church. You ever had that trouble?
Yep.
Yeah, I understood that. And so she went in there and said, "Son, you need to get up. It's time to go to church." And he said, "Mom, I'll go down there." I said, "And people don't like me." And she said, "Well, there's about three things. The reason I want you to go, today's Mother's Day." And said, "It is." I said, "Yeah." And said, "I'm your mother, number two, and I want you to go." And he said, "Well, what's the third one?" She said, "Well, you're the pastor." Well, I got through most of that. Anyway, let's do a really something really don't know. Bye-bye blues.
Okay.
Diminish or flat, whatever you say.
So he lived out there a while and he wrote this song and he played it at the festival for us and let the sunshine because it rained all the time. So.
For those of you, how many of you ever knew Buster B. Jones?
I mean, I knew him and that I saw him at your festival.
Chet said he had the best set of hands that anybody ever saw.
Unbelievable.
He was unbelievable. And the thing about it, most people that know him on this left hand, that thing was hooked together. He'd been so many fights, he'd broken, hooked together with a nylon cord. He could just jerk that thing. I said, "Buster, you're killing me." But he was a great player. And so Mike's gonna do this, and am I gonna hit you?
We used to, we used to play this a bunch of when we was out playing.
Anyway,
this is a great song, Chris. Here we go.
County and North Carolina beyond for the last 70 years plus.
Yeah.
Now, just to give you an idea, in the 50s when he played for Jim Shoemake's band, Doc Watson was his opening act.
Yeah.
Pretty good opening act, you think?
Yeah, yeah.
And he and Doc became great friends through Doc's life. His great friend of Chet Atkins, and he and some other fellas formed the Chet Atkins Appreciation Society. That last time they held it, they had 3,500 people there in Nashville honoring Chet. And this fellow was instrumental in making that happen. He's played hundreds of gigs with this gentleman right here. And in the 90s, they put out a guitar album, the Guitar Express, and a great album. And then about 1999, I believe they started the North Carolina Thumb Pickers Association. And that, of course, was put in place to preserve the kind of music you've been hearing today. So he's really played with other luminaries, with George Hamilton IV, his bass player was Don Gibson, and just to name a few. But, you know, like a lot of us pickers, and I'm not a picker, I'm a guitar owner, and but I do own a guitar. But he had to make a living, and he did that in music. And as he's told me, he sold guitars on Broad Street for 49 years. And I guess if you started playing in the 60s or the 70s like me and Eddie, that you probably bought your guitar either from L.W. Lambert at the pawn shop or from this gentleman over on Broad Street. And he's always had time to spend with pickers young and old to encourage them. He's just done so much for musicians here in our county. Now, he's a master luthier as well, and he spends his time now fixing other people's guitars. But I'll tell you, when you stop by to see him, he always has time to stop and listen to old pickers talk about their glory days. The person I'm talking about, of course, is Mr. Jason Lambert.
Yep.
Jason Lambert.
Thank you.
Jason, please come join me. Now, Jason celebrated two milestones this week, and they're both significant. On Wednesday, he celebrated his 90th birthday. Is that right? Hard to believe. And on Thursday, he celebrated an even more significant event, 71 years of marriage to his lovely young wife, Carol.
Yeah.
Now, Carol couldn't be here today, but I think we all know that we need to give her a round of applause for staying with Jason for 71 years. Well, we wanted to wish him a happy birthday. In order to do that, I wanted to rip off an old John McCutcheon song. I'll tell y'all where you come in, okay?
Okay.
Well, old Jason's sitting in his rocking chair. He's sitting there looking kind of bold. He's still got all his teeth and he's still got all his hair. This week he turned 90 years old. He's played with Doc and he's played with Chet. Finest fella that you ever met. I'd say that's true.
Thank you.
He's one picker we won't forget. Happy birthday to you. Well, it makes me think of the good old days. Happy birthday to you. Listen to the fella that can really play. Happy birthday to you. It's your birthday, we wish you many more. Health and wealth and friends by the store. Cut the cake and we'll eat some more. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Mr. Jason Lambert.
This is all yours, brother. You told it just like I told you to.
Jason, you might say words.
That's it. Just a minute. I can't let this get by. No way. Come up here.
Uh-oh.
Just going to be a minute. He
I don't know about this.
He just frowns every time.
Why not? It's your house.
I was raised in North Ireland. Amen. We had 6 acres, 13 chickens, 1 cow, and 4 pigs. And we didn't have a lot. But I learned to play guitar, as I told you, from our locally thumb style guitar from a gentleman by the name of D. Williams. Wished I had some recordings of him, but he's long gone. I'll see him in heaven. But I was a little fella, true story. Now, he looks younger than me, I know that. But my uncle Hotshot, Lundsford, he sold cars. He started an auction sale up there, North Ireland. One Saturday evening, and I'm sure he was going to play with Jim and them somewhere, but in rode, I think it was a brand new 51 Plymouth. Was it a Plymouth?
Plymouth.
Plymouth. Shiny. Everything he has is just perfect. This guy, I looked at him. I said, well, I wonder what he's going to do. he, out of that Plymouth, he pulled something, looked like that. It was an amplifier. I had never seen one. True story. And then he got a guitar out of there. Then he took it inside that auction house, and he played, I don't know what it was. I don't know if it was an Echoplex or whatever. I never, ever forgot that. He, along with Mr. Williams, has been the inspiration. Everything that I do today, I give Jason a big part of the credit, because he got me started. He lit that fire in that little boy about 6, 7 years old. And so I wanted to tell you, son, I love you, and I'll pick with you in heaven if we don't pick more.
We're going to do that.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'll tell you one on him. He came in the store, and he said, I want you to show me a lick, a couple of licks or so on the guitar. And said, show me this. And I practiced up on something, and I got it. I was real proud of it, and got it to where I could do it enough that I wasn't ashamed to do it. And it took me about 6 months to get it done. And I practiced and practiced, and I used this lick a little bit when I was playing once in a while. You know, you kind of show off a little bit, throw that in. And he came in and he mentioned to me, and he said, play that, I want to see how you do that. And I did it, and turned around and walked off. I had a customer, and about 15, 20 minutes, I went back over there, and that low down, good for nothing rascal, was doing that better than I'd ever done. And I'm going to kill him every time. That's the truth of the Lord. I'm running through the house on linoleum floor. And I said, boy, I'd like to do that. So I took that old J45. We couldn't get to play ball or anything, you know, because we didn't have no way to get there. I couldn't. So I laid in the bed and I got that where I didn't have to think about it. Then they said, you know, there's a fellow up in Nashville, Tennessee. Said he can play two songs at one time. Is this okay if I do this?
Sure.
Yeah.
Maybe I can still do this at 76. We'll see. Anyway, they said he can play two songs. I said, I wonder what those are. And somebody said, well, Yankee Doodle Dixie. Never heard of it. So, but I don't know how I learned it, but I got that Yankee Doodle thing. Anybody from the South? This ain't gonna take long, like Elizabeth Taylor told her seventh husband. This ain't gonna take long. Thank you. mistakes are intentional. I go up there. Hey, I've got to play some great guitars up there before the festival. So Ricky Skaggs and all them guys got those. You let me play some of those. You remember that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Anyway, this is a Henderson. You'll never see another one
that's,
like it.
That's the only one I ever made like that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we had some words about this thing up there on cold nights. Wayne said, he said, that thing ain't nothing but a radio with knobs on it. All right, here we go. What was it?
I'll hang on. This is me. I'll hang on with you.
while I'm tending here a while, I would like for you to play my bluebell on that big red, if you can remember it. Okay. This is one that, of course, it's a vocal song, but it's an old song from back maybe in the 20s, and I heard Jason did it, and then I heard Mike do it on Big Red, and I love the song. I'm just going to do a little rhythm on it. Just play whatever you can of it. You got Big Red, okay? Just a little more of Wayne in the monitor, please. Thank you.
since, you know, we've just been jabbering and talking too much. And none of us can sing. I can't sing at all anyway. I don't think you
not
can
much
either. Let's do this one right here, and you all might help us out and be a great place to do it. No, at least, I know there's one fella here with a St. Louis cap on.
And let's
just do this a couple of times, and what I'm hoping that you all will sing out good and loud. And after you get done singing, maybe the second time or something, we'll speed this up and make a guitar tune out the rest of it. But I know you know this. You gotta know it. So it goes like this. Good job, I thought.
A bit of Sweet Georgia. Do we remember that one?
Might.
Well, it didn't work for you.
That's right.
All righty. Whoa, Henderson. Thank you. And I never will forget, Mike took us up to Walker Center. We was doing a benefit to help Doc's brother-in-law was passing with cancer. And so Mike just couldn't wait till we could do this song. You know, Doc can really do it really well. And so he said, "Listen, Doc, how we do this song?"
No, no, no.
Well, come on, let me
He let us play before him.
I know that, but we did run through it back there. And I won't say the word. He says that, "Boys, you put too many chords in that song."
Yeah, walked back there and he's sitting like this, Wayne. You know, he'd hold his hands like this. And he said, "Son," he said, "how many chords did y'all put in that song?" And that was being kind, but he said, "I'll never play that song the same again."
All right, here we go. We'll do something.
You may kick it up.
Yeah. Can sing it. I've had laryngitis and I didn't know it anyway. But I'd love to do it.
If I sing, they'll go home.
Thank you, Governor Merle.
Would you settle for a turkey in a straw? I rarely do this in public, but I reckon it's in tune.
What you
gonna
do?
That turkey in the straw.
Oh, turkey in the straw?
Thank you. here we go. It's Henderson. Do a couple more, and we hadn't even thought about this one, but talking about time, we hadn't done that Grandfather Clock, have we, or have we?
I don't think so.
Haven't we done it?
No,
okay.
It's in G.
I ain't played it either, but I just feel like playing it the way I feel after losing that hour last night. What key? G?
I'm gonna watch you on this one.
Okay. Then we're gonna do one. Thank you. it's time to do one more and get on out of here, the clock on the wall.
I gotta get up there before it get dark.
That's true.
Get dark in them hollers up there where I live.
I called Wayne yesterday evening, and I said, Wayne, how's it going? He said, not so good. He said, the power's off, and it's 11 degrees and snowy. And
it's true, that's what I do.
And it was, it really was. He lives, now you talking about living up in the mountains? He lives up there. If you ever get a chance to go to his house, it's wonderful. It's just like, for me, it's a spiritual experience. It really is. I'm just feeling like it is. Because when you go up there, feels just like going home. I don't want to go home once I get up there with all those guitars. But we've enjoyed playing for you this afternoon. Hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks to everyone that's involved. Thanks for you. And Wayne, thanks for making these guitars.
Well, you certainly welcome.
This I will say, all those guitars you've made in the hands of those masters and some like myself, just regular players, you've blessed a many folk over this world through that music. Let's give them a hand for that. All right, tell them how you learned this song. We're going home on this.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He didn't know what.
I used to hear this tune every night. We listened on the radio to a Cincinnati radio station.
WCKY.
They advertised all kinds of things, you know, little chickens and and they actually did mail order chickens and bees and everything else. And I used to be a mailman. I was for 30 some years, and we'd get chickens every once in a while, and that was the biggest racket you ever had. They'd be wide open until you stop, and then they'd stop. Then you take off to the next mailbox, here they'd go. But this, I just always hope it wasn't somebody on the end of the route. But every kind of thing happened. But anyway, I got off on chickens, I was going to tell them about that story about my aunt that fixes chicken. Maybe there's time for one more of that.
Yeah, please.
And I'd go over to my aunts and uncles on Sunday. It reminds me, you'll be in here in the church. You know, after Sunday dinner, Mom would fix, and my granny and everybody, we always had Sunday dinner. But my aunt was a wonderful cook, and they invited me over to Sunday dinner. And I couldn't wait to get over there because she is a great cook. And I went over there and talked to my uncle a while, and after a while she come out and said, dinner's ready. Now it's dinner in the middle of the day for us. We had supper at night.
Right. Yeah, that's right.
But anyway, she come out and said, dinner's ready, and went in there, and lo and behold, she had fried chicken. And she had roasted chicken. And she had grilled chicken. And she had chicken pot pie. And she had chicken and dumplings. And maybe a couple other kinds of chicken. But that's all right. My aunt's such a great cook, and I do like chicken. That's no problem at all. We and either Phil, and after you eat a big old meal like that, what we'd always do, go out on the front porch and sit in the rocking chair and hoping that settles down a little. Out there talking to my uncle again while we was out there. We live out in the country. Here come a chicken walking around the side of the house. And that's nothing unusual at all. It's come out and started out through the yard. And I was watching that chicken. It started walking crooked, Clay. Went this way and that way.
Uh-oh.
And after a while, it just started staggering around. And before it got out to the yard gate, said that chicken just flopped over on its side.
Oh.
And I asked my uncle, what in the world happened to that chicken? And he said, I ain't got no idea. He said, they've been dying faster than we can eat them. Anyway, they used this for a theme song, and appreciate y'all listening to all of us here. We appreciate, that's pretty cool. Somebody sat all afternoon listening to guitar picking without any singing or anything. We truly appreciate y'all a lot for that. Hope you'll come up on the mountain sometime, especially the third Saturday in June would be a real good time, you know, for the festival. So thank y'all so much.